The barge is one of the most iconic structures at Vizcaya.
It's kind of one of the iconic features of Vizcaya. It serves certain purposes, but it's what people talk about, it's what people remember.
The barge was conceived of as a breakwater, but it also serves as a folly. And it's built of reinforced cast concrete, and then it's clad in native oolitic limestone, which was actually quarried on site or very near to Vizcaya. It features a sculpture program by Alexander Sterling Calder, who was a very prolific and prominent sculptor in the late 19th, early 20th century. One of a number of artworks commissioned specifically for the estate by James Searing and his artistic director, Paul Chalfin.
The barge, to put it in a bigger perspective, the house was built between 1914 and 1916. The gardens were finished in 1922, but the barge first started to be conceived in 1913, probably. There is a letter of Deering, James Deering, where he refers how he wants it to be created. Early 1916, they start construction on that whole area of the estate.
What isn't evident when you're looking at the barge from the shore is that there are incredible details on the barge.
Originally, it was much more elaborate.
The floor was designed with a decorative paver pattern. It was landscaped, and there was a summer house, a wood lattice structure at the far north end. Lights around the barge in the water, and it was only accessed by boat, by gondola.
So it was a much more lively setting than what it is today.
Vizcaya in general faces a number of challenges with regard to its preservation, just given its siting. The barge is actually situated in the water, making it one of the most vulnerable structures at the site. It is incredibly vulnerable to the elements. It is one of the most special, unique, and iconic features at the site, and yet it's only accessible from the Lower East Terrace. You're always viewing it at a distance. And it's one of the places that we've been able to observe visitors really lingering to enjoy the view.
What we want to do is to kind of create an experience for our visitors, whether it's visitors on site or online, virtual visitors, to get as much of an experience of what it would be to be on the barge.
Given the vulnerability of the barge and the fact that we are aware of its deterioration over time, how its exposure to the elements has affected the legibility of the statuary, it was really important for me as a conservator to have the site well documented, to have the barge really well documented.
Over the past year and a half, we have been working on this 3D digitization project and a laser scanning, where you get to have a virtual experience and being on the barge, which is really pretty awesome.
Our idea behind this is taking established conservation technologies of 3D documentation, which is laser scanning and photogrammetry, and then bridging that with interpretive approaches. And when I say interpretive, that really means how we engage visitors and how we tell the story of Vizcaya. From the data, we're able to create 3D prints, which can be a tactile teaching collection. There's also a touchscreen interactive involved with the project where people will be able to explore. There'll be an online component and there'll actually be a VR virtual reality component. We started off experimenting with University of Miami, the University of Florida, and a firm called Daruma Tech, actually just experimenting with 3D documentation, both photogrammetry and this laser scanning. Essentially, we're using two technologies, and that's one of the things that's unique about the project is we're creating a hybrid between these two technologies. We're using laser scanning, which essentially is a device that uses laser light to measure the distance between the surface of something and the device itself. And it takes millions of these, and it creates what's called a point cloud. So it's all of this data that represents this object. So the other technology is photogrammetry, and that essentially uses high-end digital SLR cameras, and you're taking hundreds, if not thousands, of photos we're figuring out ways to merge the two to get the most sort of highly detailed and highly accurate models possible that can also be used for general interpretation for our general visitors.
This is a sample of the kind of touchscreen interactive we might have. This just allows visitors to have sort of an incredible up-close experience with objects that are actually many meters away from them. When you start to see all the little dots, you're starting to get a sense of the point cloud that makes up all of this data that creates these really unique and amazing models that we're building to enhance visitor experience at Vizcaya.
There's also software we're able to then take those point clouds, give it to an institution like FIU MBUS, who has been our other partner, and then they work within their software to massage these models to create models that then are 3D printed.
The Vizcaya 3D printing project was really exciting to us because it engaged so many aspects of the college. Early in the project, we engaged students in communication arts to survey visitors at Vizcaya about what they knew, what they thought about 3D printing. And the rest of the project really involved 3D printing pieces of Vizcaya that would help people have a better understanding of how Vizcaya looked when it opened, and then how the climate has eroded pieces of Vizcaya and how it's changed over time. Things that we print can be touched, can be handled, can be dropped, they can be broken because they can all easily be reprinted. And they're objects that have great amount of detail, but they're not objects that are irreplaceable. The fact that we could 3D print a model of a sculpture as it had existed 100 years ago and then have a 3D print right next to it of the model today, it adds a new dimension to that person's understanding of history and the specialness of the passage of time over an object. One of the exciting things about 3D printing is that it's offering people a thing, and it's a very technical, almost scientific engineering approach to understanding art making. Essentially, it's creating a new sculpture from this 3D model that we receive.
Once this project is completed, we hope to give our visitors a more complete experience of Vizcaya and of the places that they cannot visit. And it is nice to imagine how people during Deering's time experienced Vizcaya and used Vizcaya. They went there with the gondola and had a cocktail party at sundown or so, but since that's not possible, it just completes the experience for our visitors. And besides that, a very important aspect of this whole project is also its preservation, which is a major challenge.
It was inspired by historic precedents, but it is a truly unique structure, certainly at Vizcaya, but really anywhere. And it is such a shame that our visitors don't have access to one of the most emblematic and iconic features at the site. So it's our hope that people are able to experience that.